हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज जयश्री भंगरे वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज नासिक। वेलकम टू द फिफ्थ पार्ट ऑफ माइक्रोकंट्रोलर आर्किटेक्चर एंड प्रोग्रामिंग, दैट इज टाइमर रजिस्टर्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस द टाइमर रजिस्टर्स, देन टीमोड रजिस्टर, टीकॉन रजिस्टर, मोड्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन ऑफ टाइमर्स एंड काउंटर्स। So the 8051 has two 16-bit timers, timer 0 and timer 1. As explained in the previous section or in previous video, the main oscillator of the microcontroller uses quartz crystal for its operating. As the frequency of this oscillator is precisely defined and very stable, these pulses are the most suitable for time measurement. In order to measure time between two events, it is only needed to count up pulses from this oscillator, and that is exactly what the timer is doing. So to configure this timer in a different modes, T-mode register is used, and to control the operation of the timer, TCON register is used. So here is the timer 0, that is 16-bit register. It is consist of two 8-bit registers, that is TL0 and TH0. Address of TL0 is at AH and address of TH0 is at CH. If we consider 8-bit timer, then the maximum count that will be counted by the 8-bit timer is 2 raised to 8, that is total 256 states it is counting, that is from 0 to 255. So this is the maximum count that is counted by the timer when it is used in the as a 8-bit timer. So this is represented in binary, that is 8 times 1. FFH is the value in hex, and this is the value in decimal, that is maximum count. If it is used as a 16-bit timer, then the maximum count that will be counted by the timer is 2 raised to 16, that is total 65,536 states it will count. So it counts states from 0 to 65,535. So this is the maximum count of the timer. So this is the 16-bit representation, or in binary, that is 16 times 1. FFH, that is represented in hex, and the 65,535, this is the representation in decimal. Similarly, the timer 1, the 16-bit register, that is consist of two 8-bit registers, TL1 and TH1. The address of TL1 register is 8BH, and the address of upper or a TH1 register is 8DH. So let's see how the timer will count. Suppose this is the timer 0, this is the lower 8-bit of timer 0, and this upper 8-bit of a timer 0. So if this is the initial state of timer, that is 0000, and if we apply the first clock pulse, then it will start counting as a 0001. So after applying some clock pulses, it will count up to 000F, then 001F, 00FF. Again, after overflow of a lower 8 bit, it will count to 0100. Again, it's continue counting to 0101, 0FFF. After it reaches to the maximum count, that is FFFFH, what will happen? So after application of a next clock pulse, it will reset to 0000. This is called as the overflow state of the counter. Let's see the T-mode register in detail, that is timer mode register. This is used to configure timer in a different modes. So this is an 8-bit register, So lower 4 bits of this register is used to configure timer 0 and upper 4 bits of this register is used to configure timer 1. It is not bit addressable register. So these are the lower 4 bits used to configure timer 0 and these are the upper 4 bits of TMOD register used to configure timer 1. So let's see the operation of each bit. Gate. So this bit or it is used to start and stops timers by means of a signal provided to the int pin, that is int 0 or int 1 for timer 1 and 0. So if this bit is 0, so the timer is internally controlled, that means we can start and stop the timer by way of a software. So the timer 1 or 0 is started by making the bit TRX equal to 1. TRX is nothing but a run bit for a timer 1 and a 0 if this X is equal to 0 or a 1. So let's see how this timer is controlled. So here this is the gate pin, that is input to the NOT gate. If this pin is 0, then output of this NOT gate will be 1. This is nothing but the logical OR gate, and we know that if any input of OR gate is 1, then its output will be 1. Now if we are making this TR1 bit 1, then the output will be of the output of this NOT gate AND gate will be 1, and this will close the switch and timer start counting. So here we can see that so int pin, we are not applying the any state for this int pin, or we can say that timer is operating regardless the state of this int pin. If gate is 1, then the hardware way of starting and stopping the timer by software and an external source. That means the operation of timer will depend on the state of int pin. So let's see. Now if the gate is 1, then output of this NOT gate will be 0. So now this bit of OR gate is 0, then output will be 0. If we turn on the timer, so because of this second input to AND gate is 0, output will be 0. So this will not connect or close this the switch and timer will not start. If we make this int pin equal to 1, now the output of this OR gate will be 1. This will closes the switch and timer will start counting. So here we can say that if gate pin is 1, the operation of timer will depend on the state of int X pin. Next bit of TMOD register is C/T bar. That means the timer can be used as a timer or a counter. So when this pin is 0, the timer 1 or 0 counts the internal clock pulse. Here, this is nothing but the crystal oscillator, that means the CPU clock. And this is the structure. We are making gate 0, so that will turn on the timer regardless the state of int pin. So here timer 1 is counting the pulses from internal oscillator when this bit is 0. If we make this bit equal to 1, then timer 1 or 0 counts the external clock pulses getting at pin TX, that is timer 1 or timer 0. If we make this pin equal to 1 and we are applying the external clock pulses, then the switch will be connected to the TX pin and the external clock pulses will be counted by the timer. Next bits are M1 and M0. So these bits are used to set timer mode. So there are 4 modes: mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. So when M1 and M0, they are 00, then mode 0 is selected, and that is 13 bit timer mode, in which 8 bit from THX and 5 bit from TLX are used. When M1 is 0 and M0 is 1, mode 1 is selected, and that is configured in 16 bit timer mode, in which 8 bit from THX and 8 bit from TLX they are used. When M1 is 1 and M0 is 0, the mode 2 is selected, which is 8 bit auto reload. So in which the THX holds a value which is to be reloaded into TLX each time it overflows. When M1 and M0 both bits are 1-1, mode 3 is selected, that is the split timer mode, where two separate 8 bit timers, timer 0 and is a TL0 and timer 1 is TH0, they are selected. So here are the four different modes of the timer: mode 0, in which 5 bits from TLX and 8 bit from THX are used, and TFX, which is the overflow flag, is used. Then mode 1, that is nothing but a 16 bit timer, where TLX, 8 bit from TLX and 8 bit from THX, they are used. Mode 2, that is 8 bit auto reload, where the THX holds the value which is to be loaded into TLX after overflow. Mode 3, that is the split mode, where two separate timers they are used. TCON register, that is timer control register, it is an 8 bit register, and these two bits D7 and D6 they are used for timer 1. TF0, TR0, these bits are used for timer 0, and the lower four bits they are used for interrupts. So let's see these bits one by one. TF1, that is nothing but the timer 1 overflow flag. So when this timer 1 rolls over from FF to 0000, TF1 becomes 1. That means these flags will set, otherwise it is 0. Similarly, TF0 is the timer overflow flag for timer 0. When the timer 0 rolls over from FFFF, that is from its maximum count, to 0000, TF0 becomes 1, otherwise it is 0. TR1 is the timer 1 run bit. It is used to start and stop the timer 1. When this TR1 is 0, then switch that is connected to the timer, to the system clock or the CPU clock, that is open. That means timer is off. When this bit is 1, timer is started. So when timer 1 bit is 1, it closes the switch and CPU clock is connected to the timer and timer start counting. Similarly, TR0 is the timer 0 run bit. When this bit is 0, timer is stopped, and when this bit is 1, timer is started. Next are the interrupts bit, that is IE1. So this is an external interrupt 1 aged flag. So these bits IE0 and IE1, these bits indicates whether external interrupt is activated or not. When the following aged, that is high to low, is detected at pin int 1, then this bit IE1 is equal to 1, and when that interrupt is processed, then this will be automatically cleared by the CPU. IE0, this is the external interrupt 0 aged flag. When the following aged, H2 or high to low, is detected at pin int 0, then the interrupt will encounter, and when this is processed, then this bit becomes cleared automatically by the CPU. Then int 1 and int 0, these are the internal interrupt type bits. So when this IT1 is equal to 1, following aged trigger type interrupt is considered at P1 int 1, and when this is 0, then low level trigger type interrupt is considered at P int 1. Similarly, IT0 is the internal interrupt 0 type control bit, that is used to the interrupts at int 0 pin. That means if this bit is 1, following aged trigger type interrupt is considered at pin int 0, and when it is 0, low level trigger type interrupt is considered at pin 0. So these are the questions based on this topic. Draw the format of TMOD register of 8051 microcontroller and explain the function of each bit. Draw the format of TCON register of 8051 microcontroller and explain the function of each bit. State the application of mode 1 and mode 2 of timer of 8051. Explain the role of TCON.1 and TCON.3 in the execution of external interrupt 1. Which bit of TCON belongs to EX0? Thank you.